Let's go into the night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Continues for Scottie Scheffler. Man among boys. Simply outstanding. At Augusta, so consistent, tee to green. And with his improved putting, look out. A second green jacket over the last 3 years. I know everyone now wants to start comparing, and the word ever gets thrown in there. The greatest ever. He's got a lot of work to do before we get to that particular platform. I mean, he is only won one major, right? Twice. Becomes the 18th member to win the Masters at least twice. He becomes the fourth youngest golfer to win the Masters twice, and really in some pretty neat company there. I think it was Jack, Tiger. I want to say it may have been... I'll check the third person, but nonetheless, still very impressive there. But what he has done with 35 competitive rounds so far in 2024, you have to remember it was only 54 holes out at Pebble Beach because rain got him. Mother Nature did its duty. He's played 35 competitive rounds of golf this year. He is yet to shoot over par. That is absolutely spectacular. He also joins Tiger Woods as the only player in the same year to win the Players' Championship and to go on and win the Masters. But instead of trying to put a label on him all time, let's just sit back and enjoy what this man is doing. And we're all aware of the fact that his wife could have a baby any moment now. We have a month off until Valhalla, which will be the second major for the 2024. I still don't like it. I like the way it used to be, right? The PGA Championship used to be the last of the four, but it's like everything else in the world, man. Just when you finally settle in, we're going to drop a major change on you. As a matter of fact, I think Rory McIlroy, the last time he won a major, I want to say, was 10-plus years ago, and it was at Valhalla. But for Scottie Scheffler, and there's no reason to think he won't win at least another major this year. Heck, he could win a second major, but Rory tries to become, you know, the first since Tiger Woods to win a career Grand Slam, right? We've only had six who have ever done it. Phil really made a great run at it. Of course, Phil and his demons were the United States Open. For Rory McIlroy, once again, it is there at Augusta. Ended up with a tied for 22nd, not even close at this particular time. He's only 34 years of age. You see guys like Mickelson out there. You see Tiger out there. You see a guy like Jose Maria Olazabal celebrating 30 and 25 years, respectively, of winning green jackets. Yeah, you can get a little bit longer in the tooth and absolutely still win. And at 34, that's nowhere near being considered long in the tooth. Not for this particular sport, but it still feels as though it is a ways away for Rory McIlroy. When you look at Scottie Scheffler, there's so much to admire. First of all, icicles in his veins. He is not bothered. Adversity, not much, but when it does arrive, okay? I tell you where I thought the most adversity for him came in this entire tournament. That was when he missed a 2.5 to 3 foot putt on the par 4 fifth hole on Friday. And if you remember, then it was the par 3 sixth, and he was way left. Now, he was able to grind and get out of there with a par after missing the easy par putt on 5 and settling for a 5, you know, one over a bogey. And then his shot off the tee on 7 really went right, and it went into the woods, and he was lost. He ended up bogeying then as well. So that there felt like there was maybe a 35 to 40 minute period where Scottie Scheffler was really fighting it. You know, he had a couple of bogeys, but he was doing things that he doesn't normally do. Every golfer goes through this. It's how you respond. And, you know, we heard that ridiculous rate that I don't know how many rounds it had actually registered towards, but PGA Tour Radio, Masters Radio, as well as listening to them on CBS, kept telling us that at 47%, that is actually what he has done, regardless of the amount of time, where it has been after a bogey, he responds immediately with a birdie. And that's what he did Friday on number eight, the par five eighth hole. After two bogeys and three holes, he responded with the birdie there on the eighth hole with a birdie four back on Friday. That was really it. I mean, he didn't seem to be rattled. And there were points in this tournament where, you know, you look at Ludvig Åberg, who had it within a stroke. And unfortunately for Åberg, and the same applies really for Colin Morikawa and Max Homa, they were eaten up by Amen Corner. Okay, the hardest hole on the golf course, and I know statistically you can bring up maybe another hole or two, but when you get to the par for 11th hole, it is petrifying to so many. And what happened to Åberg? Well, he had a double on 11. He posted a six. Same with Colin Morikawa. He had a double on 11. You look at Max Homa. He ended up having the double on 12, the par three. That got him. But that's why we call it Amen Corner. That's why we have seen golfers over the years flourish, be able to take advantage of others who make mistakes. And I just can't even imagine what the pressure must be like going through those three holes. And that was really it. Scheffler, even though he did bogey number 11, parred 12, ended up getting a birdie on, a birdie on 13. So he was able to get through those three holes at even par. And then, of course, that Sunday round for him, he ended up having seven overall, won the event at 11 under par, and ended up getting it done with really an enormous lead. What was all said and done, you know, winning it by four strokes. No pressure. Remember when he won 2 years ago? Or I guess it's now 3 years ago. He actually four-putted on 18 and still ended up winning by three strokes. So, you know, Scottie Scheffler making that walk up 18, there's zero pressure at all. He's already completely put away the event, and he did so again yesterday. I do think that the appreciation, though, is for just what he is like to observe, okay? His footwork is a mess. Certainly his back foot, and you know, I'm not going to sit here and tell you that I know a lot about golfing when it comes to swinging the club or doing things this way, doing things that way. I never give advice when I play golf. I mean, I'm just trying to figure out what to do myself. But it almost feels like the way that Scottie Scheffler moves that back foot, and he's the most talented player right now on the planet, it's reminiscent a little bit to what Ichiro did in the batter's box, or what Rod Carew did in the batter's box, or what we see Patrick Mahomes do now as a quarterback, you know, with his release, some of the stuff, including sidearm. And what I mean by that is I'm sure golf coaches all throughout the United States of America, and really around the world for that matter, are like, please do not watch Scottie Scheffler in his feet if you're a young golfer. Just like I imagine quarterback coaches, Denny Thompson, oh, by the way, is going to join us coming up next hour. I talked with Denny today at the Guggen. He's been working with Jordan Travis. He's been working with Caleb Williams. He's been working with a lot of quarterbacks. So it's been a little bit since I've had Denny on the program. That's coming up at 7 o'clock tonight. Looking forward to that conversation with him. But anyway, back to Scheffler. Despite the fact that he really moves around that right foot, he's the greatest ball striker on the planet. And this is where it's legendary, okay? I love the term ball striker. I've always wondered, how do you effectively and accurately measure that? You know, mathematically speaking, analytically speaking, how do we really know if the golfer hits it on the sweet spot. You can tell that in baseball, right? Even though the ball's moving 95 miles an hour, your eyes will tell you that. And I guess maybe for those who are really fond of the sport of golf, you can get a little bit of that as far as a feel as well. But of course, golf is a totally different sport. If you get it up, you know, in the jet stream, take advantage of the wind, whether it's blowing left or right or straight in your back, or obviously the hazards of it being in your face, it can affect things more than what we see in baseball. Nonetheless, there's no one like him right now on the PGA Tour. He is so consistent off the tee. I mean, this guy hits fairways. Again, I told you about the Friday round where he struggled a little bit, particularly on 7, where he missed it right. He, every single week that he plays, is consistently one of the highest-ranked golfers in greens and regulation, also in fairways hit. I think his short game is underrated, but I think for most, we forget about that. Phil was really rewarded for his short game, you know, for his lob wedges. Tiger was phenomenal. Tiger's short game back in the day was spectacular. And also, Tiger never missed putts that he had to make. Let's just get that out right now. Scheffler is an improving putter, right? But it's certainly the Achilles heel. The only way that Scottie Scheffler is going to lose an event is like what he did a few weeks ago in Houston. He won at Bay Hill. He won at the Players. He needed to make, what was that, an 8-10-footer in Houston? It may have been a little bit shorter. I actually have forgotten. It would have forced a playoff, and he missed it. That's really the only part of his game that you can look at right now and say he has to get better there. However, how many big putts did you watch him make on Saturday and Sunday where he had to roll them in? And for the most part, they fell. So just sit back and enjoy this. It's pretty incredible right now what Scottie Scheffler has been able to do. And he's going to take some time off. Obviously, his wife is expected to have their first child any day now. Got to believe he'll be ready for Valhalla, as so many others of these great golfers will be as well. But what a phenomenal weekend. Really enjoyed it. I love the fact that the scoring was down. You know, Friday's round was brutal with the wind. And there's been many that have been out at Augusta forever that will say this year on that Friday was the worst that they had ever seen the wind. And I loved it. I love watching these guys grind. I have the utmost respect for them as athletes, but to watch them struggle, frankly, is kind of a cool deal. And, you know, there'll be other events coming up, maybe as early as this weekend in New Orleans, where, you know, guys will be minus 20, minus 22, minus 24, whatever. That was not the case at the Masters. Also want to spend a quick second and salute Vern Lundquist. I'm a fan, always have been a fan. I thought he was asked to leave way too early in college football, covering the SEC on CBS. Going to miss him above his perch, if you will, on the tower. It felt like he didn't really get a lot of opportunities this year, unlike years past. It feels like the current CBS staff is really long-winded. Just watching everything, it would feel like when they would go to 16, it would be like, you know, let's go to 16. It'd be Vern Lundquist, and, you know, Colin Morikawa would already be in his backswing, so all Vern Lundquist could give you was, and it's Colin Morikawa. You know, it's kind of like whoever's speaking before, wrap it up. You know, let's get the Vern. Let's give, and I know at the end he got his parting shot and he got to say goodbye and he was choked up and that was all very cool, but it just kind of felt that way to me. I wanted a little bit more Vern in his latest and last Masters, but what a phenomenal career. He's 83, 40 years at the Masters, and hopefully he'll have a real good retirement. I'll miss him. I miss him in college football, just like I miss Brent Musburger in college football. I mean, I'm sorry. You take away It seems like Keith Jackson was missed by everyone. The Brent Musburger thing was an acquired taste. There was either a love or a hate. And I'll never get the hate. You know, his You Are Looking Live was a staple, historically speaking, in college football. And, you know, Vern Lundquist, to me, much better than Brad Nessler. It doesn't matter anymore. You folks aren't going to watch. And what are they going to have, the Big Ten? I mean, here we go. It's Brad Nessler and what's his name? The former Gary Danielson. Great to have you with us. It's Indiana-Iowa football. High noon. We're looking for a thriller today. Play the under. We expect it to be a 14-13 type game. I mean, no one's going to watch around here, right? With the SEC moving on to ESPN. All right, we're going to get the football coming up here in just a couple of minutes. Dustin Adams is going to join us, NFL draft analyst, A to Z Sports. Does a really good job out in Indianapolis. Of course, we are a week and a few days away from the NFL draft. Thursday, we get a treat. We get to talk to Trent Baalke and Doug Peterson. That's going to be Thursday afternoon, exactly 1 week away from the NFL draft. So all the information is in, right? They're just dotting a couple of I's, crossing a couple of T's. And I think at this particular time, it's like massive recheck. You know, just a little bit more due diligence. How thorough have you really evaluated this guy? And I'm not talking about film study. I'm not talking about whether or not a guy's hips can turn and he can run with you. I'm not talking about whether or not you can jam a wide receiver at the line of scrimmage. I'm talking about whether or not he is a good human being. All right? What is he really like? Is he a good teammate? Is he a good practice player? Is his motor always running? How does he treat individuals? How did he treat his classmates? How did he treat, you know, half the world now goes from one school to another, right? Mommy, I'm not a starter. Transfer, son. How did he treat people at the school he was once at before he went to the school that he is now at? That is where, you know, just intense background checks come into play. You're making millions and millions of dollars worth of a huge decision. You take the most talented player, but you got to find out everything else. This regime hasn't done it, but the former regime missed. They drafted turds. Right? Leonard Fournette, turd. Jalen Ramsey, turd. The list goes on and on and on. Yannick Ngakoue, turd. You know, not good teammates, not good human beings. There's no other way to say it. You know, decent football players, at least Jalen is. How do you miss on? How did you not know that C.J. Henderson had massive, enormous mental health situations? When he's a driver in three wood from Jacksonville. I knew it. COVID? Oh, it was COVID? I mean, you could read about it on bathroom walls. Everyone knew that C.J. Henderson had issues. So you can't miss in that area. But as far as what they do physically, that work's done. This is the final observation. And what they're like character-wise. And the other part of it is medical, which I have no clue on, right? Doctors, team doctors are separate, all 32. There are some that will clear you. There are some that will say it's fine. There are others that will say, uh-uh, let's red flag this. I don't like what I see. I don't like how that particular bone structure looks. I don't like how those ligaments look. I don't know. I'm out of but it's a huge part of it, medically speaking. Had a blast today out at the Guggen. Team Blue was outstanding. D-Rock, Derek Redding was a big winner with a putt, with a putter in his hand. Won 100 beans. He's of course, with GFL, Green for Life. Joshua Chang, the trophy husband, was, as expected, just really carrying the team on his back. And Aaron Beasley, man, tee to green. great round for him as well, the former Jaguar, along with yours truly. We all shot, all shot in like the mid-80s. I think I shot an 86. We were all around that number, but it was another spectacular day. So thank you to everyone involved over there at Hidden Hills. Saw a lot of great 1010XL and 92.5 FM listeners. A lot of hard work by our radio station, the entire sales team, all the way through to our interns. It was just a, you know, if you give us weather like today, how can it not be a success? And it was. Gets better every year. Gets bigger every year. Thank you to all the sponsors and everyone involved. But I'm going to tell you right now, the team of Ballou, Beasley, Derek Redding, and Joshua Chang, you're going to be pretty hard-pressed to find a foursome who had more fun than us. Of course, the only setback, JJ, I played stone sober.
Which sucks, but you got work and it's a Monday. So what, you guys played teams, like against someone else, another foursome?
No, we each played our own ball.
Okay.
And we shot well. I'll let it out now that it's over. Beasley and I went out last week and played a practice round just to try to get a little bit of an understanding as to how things are tee to green. There's a lot of blind spots at Hidden Hills. And if you're not familiar with the golf course, it can catch you. And, you know, it's starting to get warm now. But for the most part, courses here in Jacksonville, if you, you know, depending on your approach, the ball's still really going to roll out on you, right? It hasn't completely thawed out. There hasn't been a ton of rain, so that everything's not as soft as they would like. I'm not talking about greens here. You can work in the greens. I'm talking about fairways. So, yeah, it had a little bit more roll to it than perhaps it may not have if, let's say, we'd been getting a ton of rain. But
who had the lowest score out of 10-10 people?
I imagine Prosser did.
Hmm.
He played with Matt Every today. Talked with him, you know, formerly on the PGA Tour. Matt's a really good guy. I actually enjoy talking golf with him. I don't know what Prosser shot, to be honest with you, but my guess is that he probably shot in the low 80s, unless he had a spectacular round. Maybe shot in the high 70s. I don't know, but it was a fun day. So thank you to all who were involved. And you know what? I could see the ball. That wasn't the problem. That's because of the good folks over at Schmunez Vision. That's never my issue on the golf course. Seeing the ball, seeing it tee to green, all right? Being able to look at things, and you put the golf ranger up and you measure it. It says 120 yards and you pull it down. You're like, 120 yards? It looks like it's 100 yards. No, I don't deal with that because I have 20/20 eyes, and that's because I regularly go my scheduled visits with Schmunez Vision. If your eyes are starting to leave you a little bit, all right, maybe you're getting sideways on some stuff. Maybe you're waking up and you're like, damn, what's going on? Blurry vision, fatigue sets in late at night, maybe some spotting in your eyes. Well, it's time for a checkup. Just check them out online. Go to Schmunez Vision. There's so much more than just contacts and glasses. I'm talking about a practice here where you're talking about the Schmunezes, and that includes Dr. Catherine Schmunez, his fellowship training, cornea cataract surgery, all refractive surgery. How about Dr. Neil Schmunez, 8.5 years ago, performed surgery in my right eye. I want you to look at them online, and I want you to trust them. It's amazing how we push back eye care. Why? Why would you? I mean, just ask yourself that right now, driving home. Why do you always push back? I'll get to it next month. No. Stop right there, okay? Get your eyes looked at by the best in Jacksonville. That is Schmunez Vision. Care you can see. Coming up next, let's switch our attention to the National Football League. We are a week and a couple of days away from the Jaguars and the entire NFL in their draft. Destin Adams of NFL, make that of A to Z Sports. He's an NFL draft analyst. He's a good guest. We've had him on a couple of times. He makes a return trip again, and he joins us next.
Center, Brad Meester.
Big shout out to everybody in Duval.
I'm Brad Meester on 1010 XL 92.5 FM.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contracting. And right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement. Plus, no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
Are you suffering from shoulder pain? If you have clicking and popping in the shoulder joint, persistent pain that intensifies with use, an inability to lift your arm over your head, or a tingling, burning sensation in the shoulder, elbow, or wrist, waiting to see a doctor could make your injury worse. Baptist Health and Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute have innovative and effective treatment options available right now to relieve your pain and restore your mobility. Don't wait. Call 904-JOI-2000.
Let's go! Looking for a night of action without a big hit to your bankroll? This Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena, cheer on your Sharks as they go all in against the Las Vegas Nighthawks. See what I did there? With tickets as low as $15, you can't find this kind of family, affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com.
Let's go!
Decades night. Find that old members-only jacket or favorite flannel shirt. We're celebrating the 90s. What's your favorite decade?
Let's go!
Don't miss the fun this Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena. For tickets, call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com. That's tickets at 904-621-0700.
Let's go! Let's go!
Instant Keys. Instant Keys. You don't have to go to the dealer. Instant Keys comes to you. Call 904-722-1111.
Instant Keys saves the day if you've lost or broken keys. They can program new keys and remotes for nearly every make and model of vehicle at a fraction of the dealership cost. Fast, honest, and reliable locksmith service. Call Instant Keys, 722-1111.
It's Need to Breathe, live at Daly's Place, April 28th. For your last chance to win tickets to Need to Breathe, text BREATHE to the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures at 641-1010 now.
Hey, sports fans, this is Hayes Carlyon from MyBookie. Look, we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino canceled because real life came calling. Well, MyBookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action, all from the comfort of your own home. I love the live casino. The roulette is awesome. It's so easy and so much fun. Just go to MyBookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find live dealers ready to deal or spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience when the action is in your hands. Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL, and a revamped loyalty program ensures a host of exclusive VIP perks. So sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win, only with MyBookie.
Pross, I'm thinking about changing my name.
Again? You're already the media mogul, the straw that stirs the drink, the Duke of Pablo Bay. Now what?
Refer to me as Dreamfinders Danny Hicken.
What in the blazes? Is this a cash grab?
No, it's just that I believe so much in Dreamfinders Homes. 20 locations in Northeast Florida, official home builder of Jags and Gators. Great opportunity for first-time homeowners.
All right. Dreamfinders Danny it is.
Did I mention the lowest interest rates you can find? Visit DreamfindersHomes.com. Now let Dreamfinders Danny celebrate through the majesty of song. Dream finders,
oh, brother.
I believe they will build your
stop.
Home. Just
rolling, rolling, rolling. We're all calling, rolling. The toilet's overflowing. Oh,
when you've got a leak and can't wait a week, call Roland Reese Plumbing.
206-0-7059.
Attention real estate agents, loan officers, and mortgage professionals. Trust your real estate closings to the expertise of St. John's Title, LLC. As a board-certified attorney-owned and operated firm with years of experience, St. John's Title provides the utmost of precision and professionalism. With conveniently located offices and in-home remote closing options, our customer-first approach ensures a seamless process tailored to your timeline. Join our team of experts and five-star testimonials from customers across the First Coast. Choose St. John's Title.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
God, I know all you hardcore fans are like, enough on golf, Baloo, for crying out loud. Get back to what we really cared about. That is the NFL. That is the Jaguars. Tough to believe. We're a week and a couple of days away from the NFL draft. Thursday is going to be a lot of fun. All right, our weekly visit, or our yearly visit, 1 week away, I should say, with both Trent Baalke and Doug Peterson, both of which I think have really said more as opposed to less with their season-ending press conferences, certainly from the combine, and any other time that they've met with us, including after a couple of big free agent signings that came in. So this will be interesting, and we'll do that coming up on Thursday. Right now, though, let's stay with the NFL draft. Good to bring back Destin Adams. Of course, he's an NFL draft analyst from A to Z Sports NFL, and he goes into the night with Rick Baloo. Destin, thanks for a couple of minutes.
Oh, anytime. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, good to have you back. You know, I've been saying this for a little bit now. I know you're based out of Indianapolis and you cover the Colts as well. In a lot of circles, it feels like who Indy picks at 15 may be the guy that Jacksonville wants at 17.
Yeah, I mean, the Colts and Jaguars have a lot of similar needs. And being at 15 and 17 – like that, unfortunate for the Jaguars to be two picks behind the Colts there. But I think because both teams have that top two need, are they going to go receiver? Are they going to go corner? It could almost be a situation to where if the Colts go corner, maybe it pushes the Jaguars to go receiver if they take their guy at that position. So it'll be interesting to see how that falls. But, yeah, it's not every year you get to see two divisional opponents that close in the order of the draft, for sure.
Yeah, I'm in the minority here because I'm all about building the offense, give Trevor Lawrence everything he needs, and then just try to outscore your opponents. But the feeling is, yes, it is going to be a corner. I go offensive line, even though they've totally redone that or restructured contracts, re-signed guys, and brought in Mitch Morris. The feeling is maybe a wide receiver. But you're right. It feels like it's a corner. So let me ask you straight up. Do you think that Quinyon Mitchell, Terrion Arnold, the two highest-ranked corners, do you think either one of those two will be available for Jacksonville at 17?
I do. I mean, I think there's going to be a run on multiple different positions that are really highly coveted across the league. I mean, everyone knows that the quarterback position is getting a lot of love with four quarterbacks likely coming off the board before either the Colts at 15 or the Jaguars at 17 come on the clock. There's going to be a run on offensive tackles eventually, and that when that run starts, we could see three to five tackles come off the board pretty much back-to-back because of how highly the NFL views that position group in this class. Those three edge rushers are going to be interesting because there seems to be a belief around the league that the drop-off from number three to four, an edge rusher in this class, is pretty drastic.
Mm-hmm.
So if a team – let's say the Falcons at 8 take the first edge rusher, that could cause a domino effect at edge rusher. I think corner is one of those positions to where I think the top five in this class ended up pretty – they're viewed pretty similarly across the league, depending on the scheme you play. Probably depends on how they have them ranked individually.
Yeah.
But I don't think there's a drastic talent drop-off as if – like similar positions like edge rusher that could cause it to where these corners drop a little bit in the first.
Okay. You know that Trent Baalke, when we talk to him on Thursday, they're never going to come out and say, well, it was a need pick. I mean, that's free agency, right? They're going to tell us it's the best value, their highest-ranked player that was, in fact, on the board. So, with that said, it becomes a little bit of who goes right in front of them. And what we're all trying to figure out is how big of a drop-off is it between the second and the third corner as compared to the top three wide receivers. And then you get to a guy like Brian Thomas Jr., if he's available at 17, who would be the fourth wide receiver. I hope you understand what I'm getting at, but that becomes almost, all right, you trust your board, but it goes to a position where there is a need. I sense that there could be a little bit of confusion here for Jacksonville if it doesn't go the way they expect it to.
Yeah, I mean, I think if I were in charge of a team, and obviously no one's come a-calling to give me that job yet, but if I were, like, I think you look at this class and how talented it is in those top three rounds to where it's almost which day two talent do you like best between that receiver and corner group? Because I think there's starting-level talent for both that teams are going to get to draft in that second round. But if on your board you have more receivers that you feel comfortable with, and for Jacksonville specifically, obviously, they want that big-bodied X receiver to be on the outside, let Kirk live in the slot, Gabe Davis to be that deep threat on the outside they signed this offseason. So you mentioned Brian Thomas Jr. He has that potential to be that type of guy. But how many guys do they view in this class that they are comfortable to let start on the outside day one on day two? And if there's not a lot of them, like, I feel like you have to pounce on Brian Thomas Jr. and Adoni Mitchell out of Texas. Because while this receiver class is really solid and really talented, there's not a whole lot of that X-style, big-body, 50-50 ball type receiver. So if you're really going to target that position, which is what the Jacksonville Jaguars need at receiver, in my opinion, like, I almost feel like it'd be smarter for the Jaguars to take that receiver in the first and then add talent at corner in the second.
Yeah, at pick number 48, Jacksonville needs to make a splash here. They did not last year with their second, third, and both fourth-round picks. Neither one of the four panned out. Not to say that they won't pan out in year two, but they didn't last year as rookies, and they're going to need more production from their rookie draft class coming up this year. Destin Adams, our guest, A to Z Sports NFL, if you want to get the latest from him on Twitter. All right, let's throw Indy into the mix, too, at 15, along with Jacksonville at 17. I don't like the talk of moving up for the reason that you just gave. I think they have to get two good football players, one at 17, one at 48. Do you see a scenario where Jacksonville, and again, I feel like in a lot of circles, Indy may be taking the guy that Jacksonville wants, and you're there in that city. Either the Colts or the Jaguars try to package something to move up 5-6 spots because there's a guy that they absolutely have to have.
Yeah, so I mean, when you're looking at this receiver class, for example, both teams could use that one extra receiver to kind of push them over the hump. I think that's where things get different a little bit between the Jaguars and Colts. I think the Colts need that Gabe Davis type receiver to stretch the field, whereas the Jaguars are looking for that big-bodied receiver, which the difference between that is, when you look at the Colts, that's probably Malik Nabers that they would like to go get. Mm-hmm. You're looking at the Jaguars, you're probably thinking Roman Dunze is that guy of those top three receivers that may fit what the Jaguars need a little better. So I've heard these receivers ranked very differently across the entire league as I've talked to league reps. And it's all dependent on what you need at receiver. So I have a feeling, and this is just a gut feeling from everything I've heard, that one of those top three receivers is going to end up going a little later than people think. I think around that pick 10 mark could be in play. So that's when it comes into question of should a team like Indy, should a team like Jacksonville trade up for that receiver if you can do so without – because once you're in that 5-7 pick range away from that 10th pick, it's not going to cost you a future first to move up anymore. Are you willing to get a little aggressive to get – that tier one level receiver in this class? I mean, the Colts have never traded up in round one during Chris Ballard's tenure. That is a factual stat that I've dealt with over the time of covering the Colts. The Jaguars with Trent Baalke, I think Trent has been a little bit more aggressive than what we've seen of Ballard. So if I had to pick one of those two teams to be aggressive and take that swing, it's probably Jacksonville.
Yeah, Trent Bug has been very aggressive, and some of the moves he's made have worked out. But last year he kept trading and trading and trading, kept acquiring picks. I mean, he had all these six-round picks and then couldn't get anyone to dance with him. So, you know, he was basically stuck with him. I hope he doesn't go down that same road again coming up this year. All right, final question for you. Destin, this team is better, but there's still needs. Another one for me is depth at defensive tackle, you know, the interior defensive line. Can you find guys there third, fourth round?
I think so. I really like this defensive tackle class. It's actually one of the positions in this class that I think gets a little bit undervalued. I mean, they have the top guys that obviously you're not talking about here, but I think there's a lot of high upside options that can be considered in that end of day two, early day three. Dwayne Carter out of Duke is a guy that's going to go in that third to fourth round. Really like his game. Obviously, there's been some guys that have rose up boards that we'll see how high they end up going. If you would have asked me before the combine, I would have said a guy like Braden Fisk out of Florida State. Who you probably know of his game pretty well being in Florida. But before the combine, I would have said that's the range he was going in. Now people say he's going in the second round. I think Brandon Dorlis out of Oregon's a guy that's going to go in that range. That's very talented as a pass rusher. And who knows with this Tavondre Sweat situation, defensive tackle with his legal issues he's going through. A guy that was projected to go in the second round, probably going to get pushed down some boards now. We see that every year. So now a team that's in that fourth, fifth, maybe even sixth round, who knows how, depending on how teams view that issue, you could get a guy that has talent that was being viewed as the second round pick.
Destin, appreciate it as always. Thank you so much. Make sure you get everything from Destin Adams, NFL draft analyst with A2Z Sports NFL. You can check him out on Twitter. Thank you as always. We'll do it again soon.
Awesome. Appreciate you for having me.
There he goes. Destin Adams joining us based out of Indianapolis. And had to let him go. I guess what? Caitlin Carter. Is tonight the WNBA draft? He said he had something going on with that coming up. So I'm going to trust that, in fact, it is happening tonight. Boy, usually I'm talking about the Boston Marathon. Didn't even mention that today. 44 minutes into the show. I guess it doesn't really hit. Down here in the deep south. You left Boston, Baloo. You left in 1987, for crying out loud. Why are you going back to Boston? No one cares. No one cares about the Boston Marathon. No one cares about Whitey Bulger. No one cares about the U.S. Constitution. No one cares about the Bell in Hand, the oldest bar in Boston. No one cares that the Hollywood Freaks, when they created Black Mass, they couldn't leave the bar the way that it was supposed to be. The Hollywood folks had to come in and say, no, we need to change this, change that. Kind of like your new wife out there, if you're working on what? Number four, number five, good luck to you. That is going to be interesting with the DUI on that prospect from LSU. My belief, this organization doesn't touch him. That's my belief, okay? I do. I believe that character is really important to this football organization. And I disagree with it to some aspects. You need some dogs. You need some violence. You need some questionable people on your team. Don't get me wrong. If you have equal ability and you have one who's considered a good guy and one who's considered a bad guy, you take the good guy. But sometimes the bad guy does a little extra, if that makes any sense. Hey, what? 20, 30 minutes ago, I was talking about the former organization who drafted questionable character guys like Jalen and Unique and Leonard Fournette. Now, I mean, so why go back to it, right? Well, you're talking about first-round picks outside of Unique. If this guy's hovering there in the third round, fourth round, and everyone's passing him by, and he's a guy that you think can play football, I don't have a problem with it. Again, I've always said this. I don't need my Jacksonville Jaguars to walk old ladies across the road. I don't need that. You may. Okay? You may need that. I don't. I mean, Gator fans, you guys haven't won in football in what? 17, 18 years? Didn't you like it when you had Urban Meyer and you had all these guys that were breaking the law week in, week out? You had murderers. You had felons. You had all sorts of crap. You were winning. You were winning championships. Look at Miami during some of their bad days, some of their great days. Look at Florida State, some of their great days. Are you talking about the free shoes they took? Yeah, that's it. I mean, what? If they do bad things here and there, isn't it fine if you win? Oh no, this is the highest graduation rate we've ever had. And you win five games. That sucks. Don't give me graduation rate. Give me arrest rate. And give me wins and losses. I think they stay away. Look at the free agents. Look at the drafts. Character is incredibly important to this current Jaguar team. I'm surprised they hung on to Chris Claybrooks as long as they did. All right? Who's the only guy that got in trouble that I can think of?
Zay.
Right? No one. I mean, when's the last time someone's gotten in trouble in Jacksonville?
Well, I mean, having two guys arrested in one season is pretty good.
Yeah, it is. I guess. But
I think that's just like a what the front office and people say. Like, we want to have good character guys, but they don't actually care about that. Like, they would have gotten rid of Claybrooks immediately, but they didn't. They don't care. That's just something you say to the media. I don't buy it. I'm on your side.
I don't know. I don't. I just. This is a gladiator sport. This is a sport of violence. This is a sport of things that used to happen in the ditch, at the bottom of the pile, where the difference between winning and losing could be, well, I'm not going to say it on air because this is terrestrial radio. But I mean, everything nowadays, oh my God, it's so good to see you. Let me sign that jersey. Oh, hey, listen, get your tongue out of my ear. Well, that's what we do at the 50-yard line. Screw that. I mean, it's soft porn at the 50-yard line these days. They're grabbing one and, oh, it's so good to see. They're already over the loss. You're paying $18 a beer, and you're on your 16th beer, and your week's ruined, and they're grabbing one another at the 50-yard line. Oh, my God, it's so good to see you. They're already over the loss. And it also doesn't matter who's in the uniform, right? As long as they win. There's no loyalty. Guys leave all the time. Teams move them all the time. It's two-faced. So why are you going to be so upset if they go out and get a guy who broke the law? They're probably doing the exact same thing that you did many times. Driving around over the limit. Oh, I can't believe he drove. How many times? Hey, you who lives in the glass house. How many times have you driven around over the limit? Tonight's show brought to you by Patriot Roofing Service. Services specializing in all types of commercial and residential roofing and repairs. Gutters, sun tubes, skylights, military and senior citizen discounts. Give my buddy Mark a call, 982-4052. Or better yet, check him out online, Patriot Roofing Services, if you need repairs to your current roof or a brand new roof, whether it's your home or business, go to Patriot Roofing Services. All right, let's get caught up on some of these breaks. We're going to stay with the NFL. Denny Thompson's going to join us. He's been working with Caleb Williams. He's been working with a lot of guys. He's been working with Jordan Travis, okay, who's way, way down. I mean, this kid may not get drafted. He may be a fifth, sixth, seventh round pick. I don't know. He was a phenomenal college player, and he's on his way back as his rehabilitation continues. Denny Thompson's coming up. He'll join us as well on the show.
It's the fastest sport on four wheels.
This is what I've been waiting for.
This Sunday at Talladega, brought to you by the Plumbers and Pipefitters Local Union 234. From the station with the most horsepower, 1010 XL.
There are trucks, and then there's the truck, the GMC Sierra. Frank Frangie here, with available features like the V8 engine, the ultimate luxury interior, and of course, the available world's first six-function multi-pro tailgate. Nimnik Buick GMC has the largest inventory of GMC Sierras in the area. This month, save up to $10,000 off new GMC Sierra 1500 or enjoy rates as low as 1.9% APR financing. You get it at Nimnik. GMC, we are professional grade.
Have you been dreaming of enhancing your living space with top-quality custom windows and doors? Well, now's the 30-day spring sale with Renewal by Anderson. Save $300 on every window, $825 on all patio doors. Plus, no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Renewal by Anderson, a better way to a better window. Visit rbafla.com.
License number CGC1527613.
AgPro Sign and Drive event is offering 0% for 84 months with no money down on a John Deere compact utility tractor with loader. Limited time offer. Visit your local AgPro dealership today. Offer ends 4/30/24. Subject to approved credit. See dealer for details.
Attention poker enthusiasts. Get ready for unbeatable action at Best Bet with locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and St. Augustine. On April 19th and 20th, dive into the excitement with $1,500 high hands every 30 minutes. And save the date for April 27th, because it's 24-karat gold day at Best Bet Jacksonville, where we're dealing out $24,000 in prizes throughout the day, starting at 10 a.m. Want in on the action? Visit bestbetjacks.com for all the details. That's bestbetjacks.com.
At Andy's Automotive and Truck Services, they know that your company's fleet is more than just a bunch of cars and trucks. It's your livelihood, your reputation, your pride. So when you need routine fleet maintenance or emergency repairs, Andy's offers after-hours and mobile service to minimize your downtime and keep your fleet running like new. While you care for your employees and customers, rest assured Andy's Automotive will take care of your fleet. Visit the team at andysats.com.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 15th, 1947, Jackie Robinson becomes the first African-American to play in U.S. Major League Baseball on the Dodgers.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see him in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
If you're ready to transform your yard with a fence that stands out, elevate your curb appeal with Superior Fence and Rail. Superior takes pride in offering first-class service, friendly installers, and unmatched fence products. Mention this ad and get $250 off your next project. It's time to get off the fence and call today.
When you're on the fence, about a fence, SuperiorFenceAndRail.com.
Florida Home AC, the official AC partner of the Jaguars. Make them your AC partner with honest cost estimates before they start the work with no hidden fees. Call 777-4300 for Florida Home AC.
Jumbo Shrimp Baseball presented by FIS with tickets starting at just $5 is back at 1-to-1 Financial Ballpark this weekend. Don't miss Coors Light Thirsty Thursday, Fireworks Friday and Saturday, and Military Appreciation on Sunday Family Fun Day. Tickets start at just $5. Log on to jackshrimp.com. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball. Affordable, family, fun.
Oh,
Let's fire up the flavor and ignite those appetites. Let's slow down and smell the barbecue. Because all your favorites are smoked for hours and ready for eating when you are. From our famous ribs to slow-smoked pork. Enjoy some perfection by the plateful, safely in our dining room or in the comfort of your home. With curbside pickup, drive-through, and delivery. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmasters since 68.
New and pre-owned firearms are always in stock at Beach's Jewelry and Pawn in Jacksonville Beach. Want a new sidearm or rifle? Brands like Kimbar, Smith & Wesson, Sig Sauer, and Beretta. No lines, no hassle. Beach's Jewelry and Pawn in Jacksonville Beach.
Elevate your party game to the next level with Mystic Cornhole Company. Visit their showroom now on the corner of Hogan and Parental Home Road. It's your one-stop destination for all things cornhole. MysticCornhole.com.
Tone 10XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2.
Let me tell you how it will be. There's one for you, 19 for me.
Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
We're going to tax the rich and feed the poor. And we're going to work really, really hard. Some of us wrote checks today that we're not happy about. But you go, Uncle. You keep us free. I may have said Tavondre Sweat at LSU. It's Texas, the big Texan, 6'4½", 366 pounds. Hit with a DUI. It's bad. It's bad news. I just don't like when people act like, oh, I never did it. You know? People are such liars, such frauds. Talk about drinking all the time. I got a GF who doesn't drink. I'm actually taking tomorrow off. I'm going to blaze into the night with Britt Floyd over at the Florida Theater. I'm not driving. I will not drive if I've been drinking. But I did years and years and years ago. And I'm not proud of it. But I don't run away from it. It's awful. Especially if someone innocent is hurt. But don't act like this guy's a mass murderer, okay? Don't act like he's Aaron Hernandez. Don't act like he's O.J. Simpson. He did something that 99% of the listening audience has done before. If he's going to free fall in the draft, and is this city going to, oh, I'm not going to go. I'm not going to go to games. They selected Tavondre Sweat. I got a DUI. So hypocritical. It's amazing. What do you got over there, JJ? You got some good news? You got a giveaway for us?
We do. We have one of Jacksonville's favorite events this weekend, Guns and Hoses.
Love it.
A lot of us go every year. Some of us have been guest judges.
Mm-hmm.
But if you don't know, it's firefighters versus cops.
And it's a great event.
And they're pretty damn impressive. You think like amateur fighters, they don't know what they're doing. Absolutely not. I've come away from this event all the time being impressed every single time. So we have a pair of tickets to the annual Guns and Hoses Fight Night. This year it will be at the UNF Arena, Saturday, April 20th. How do we want to do this?
We were looking for one name. It was fourth youngest to win the Masters twice. It was Jack, Tiger, and
Blank and Scheffler.
Scheffler, there's only one other, correct?
Yes.
We need that name. You give us that name at 641-1010. You also get an opportunity to talk with JJ LaSelva. You're off to Guns and Hoses, folks. I was a judge for years. It is a spectacular event right here in the city. You need to go. We're giving you tickets right now. Call 641-1010 to win a pair. coming up this weekend. On the other side as well, let's bring in Denny Thompson. Let's talk some quarterbacks leaving the game of college on their way to the NFL. He goes into the night with J.J. LaSelva and Rick Bellini.
XL1010.
Code invalid.
That's not good. Is that good?
What the hell did you do?
I entered the ignition code, that's all.
Self-destruct sequence activated.
1010XL.
Baloo for Shenactri Chiropractic. They've helped me get rid of my headaches and pain in my neck and back. Are you suffering from an auto accident? What about TMJ pain? Headaches associated with jaw clenching, grinding of the teeth, or stress-related disorders, Shenactri Chiropractic has a physical therapist on staff for rehabilitation, quality chiropractic care, dry needling massage, and acupuncture. Call 743-6700. Or go to ShenactriDC.com.
Brian and Angela Wall here with Window World. You've heard us talk about it. Window World, the number one window replacement company in the USA, selling over 1 million windows each year for the past 8 years.
That's a lot of satisfied customers and why J.D. Powers has awarded Window World best in customer satisfaction 3 out of 4 years.
Window World stands behind their slogan, simply the best for less. With Window World, you get top quality windows at a price that leaves more of your money in your bank account, and you get the absolute best guarantee there is in the window replacement industry. When compared to our competition, there is none. See for yourself. Call the competition. Get quotes from them. But before you buy, get Window World's free estimate and compare the quality of the windows and the price.
You'll see.
And when your new Window World windows are installed and they're saving you money on your energy bills, if anything goes wrong with those windows, Window World and I will be there to make it right. That's my guarantee.
Call Window World today. Start saving money on your new windows and your energy bills and take vacation with your savings. Window World, online at windowworldneflorida.com.
Window World, simply the best for less. Thank you for your business.
Window World also offers energy-efficient doors and siding.
Hey, I know we love our happy hours, but have you been to Mr. Chubby's Wings for lunch lately?
Yep, their new specials are awesome. I eat lunch there all the time.
I went this week and got wings, a drink, and chips for $8.
As usual, the best prices in town. You can't hardly find anyone doing $8 lunch anymore.
I know. I'm saving my money for the weekends with $8 lunch specials.
Save your money for the weekends. Enjoy $8 lunch specials Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Three locations serving you for all sports all year. Mr. Chubby's Wings, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
The flagship station of the Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Hey sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. Look, we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino canceled because real life came calling. Well, MyBookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action, all from the comfort of your own home. I love the live casino. The roulette is awesome. It's so easy and so much fun. Just go to MyBookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find live dealers ready to deal or spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience when the action is in your hands. Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL and a revamped loyalty program ensures a host of exclusive VIP perks. So sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win, only with MyBookie.
The 2024 draft is almost here.
The Jaguars are now on the clock.
Join us at Evermank Stadium Thursday, April 25th for the official
Duval
draft party presented by Donovan Air Electric and Plumbing. Be there as the Jaguars make the 17th overall pick and don't miss the unveiling of the official 30th season logo that you voted on. We're getting the party started at 7 p.m. Tickets are free, so register today at jaguars.com/draft party. We can't wait to see you there.
The Jacksonville Jaguars select...
David Lane here again for Southeast Orthopedic Specialists. After several surgeries for age-old issues, mainly my back and shoulders, there's no doubt that Southeast Orthopedic Specialist is my sustaining resource for living pain-free. Take it from me, and I'm being really honest here, there's no better orthopedic facility here in Jacksonville.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Visionaries, builders, and doers, are you ready to change the world? Miller Electric is your opportunity to shape the future. Miller Electric is leading the charge in electric vehicle technology with our state-of-the-art EV Innovation Design Center. We're working to create a sustainable future. We're also the proud partners of the Jacksonville Jaguars, powering their performance at the brand-new Miller Electric Center. Miller Electric, we provide competitive pay, unbeatable benefits. Apply today. MillerCareers.com, Miller Electric, an equal opportunity employer.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Now, the quarterback whisperer, Denny Thompson.
Okay, bring it in.
Brought to you by Tyson Sound and Security, security and automation experts, and George Moore Chevrolet.
1, 2, 3. Play.
I saw Denny Thompson today out at the Guggen. He's getting ready to hit the road to Athens, Georgia. But we got him for a couple of minutes, and he joins us right now. What do you say, young man?
What is up, Ricky? It's good to see you today, man. Yeah. We used to see each other every day for, what, 3 years?
No.
Epic crosstalks.
Right. Yeah, epic.
My favorite part every night with crosstalk is when I would ask James, what are you guys doing tonight? And he'd go, I don't know.
Yeah, you got to make something up, right?
But you guys did a great job and you had a blast. But, hey, you got a whole bunch of big things going on right now. I'm going to ask you about that in a moment. But let's get straight to it. So, you know, tell us about your arsenal. Tell Caleb Williams, Jordan Travis, others as well.
Got a good draft class this year. We've had a good time, man. It's been a busy time. We've got Caleb Williams. We've got Austin Reed, local guy, St. Augustine, who I think will get drafted. We've got Jordan Travis. We've got Emory Jones and Davis Brin from Georgia Southern. So, yeah, we've been busy at Cortex, man, the last couple of months, but it's been fun. And this is a time of year where it's a lot of fun because up until today we had a bunch of our NFL guys in. So you kind of have that cool bleed over of guys preparing to go to the NFL and guys who are already in the NFL. And so it's a fun time of year for sure.
What makes Caleb Williams so special?
Man, that list is long, Rick. You know, the first thing that jumps out at you physically is just what he's able to do with his arm and with his body. He can take his arm any position and not really lose velocity or control over the ball. He's obviously arm talented, but you know, when you just see kind of the way he moves and maneuvers through all of this stuff and through life, he is, you know, I think, been horribly mislabeled. I think he's just a very intelligent young man who's got confidence in what he's doing. And so I think he's got a huge career ahead of him in the NFL. He's done things through motion capture and things like that we have not previously seen out of, you know, any of the quarterbacks that's come through here. So he's, you know, just really talented kid, man, and the future's bright for him for sure.
Yeah, feels like he's going to be the top overall pick. I would be shocked if it's anything but.
Yeah, me too at this point. I mean, it seems like a not very well-kept secret. And I think he's good. Like, that's a good match. Chicago, you know, in every way, Chicago's got some weapons. Caleb is very much a Chicago-style guy. Like, Caleb's not a beachy guy. He's you know, originally from that Maryland area. So it's almost like everything that we've been made to believe about Caleb, because I did not know him previous. Will Hewlett, who works with us, we all worked together. He worked with him for a while. So this was my first exposure to Caleb. And so I was completely off because I kind of not believed the narrative, but I heard the narrative. Mm-hmm. But yeah, no, I think he's perfect for the city of Chicago. I think that's a talented offense, actually, when you start to look at it. So yeah, I hope they do pull the trigger and make him number one. That would be fun.
Everything that Mike Norvell has done as of late has really worked positively for him and the team outside of this year's Orange Bowl. One mistake was 3 years ago, where in Charlotte at the ACC meetings, he brought both Jordan Travis and Mackenzie Milton, and it was a quarterback competition. And during that conversation with Jordan, I said, okay, well, you run the ball really well. Can you pass it? And he said to me, he said, I've always been a passing quarterback. My high school coach, Noah Brindis, that's all I did was pass it. I passed it at Louisville. When I got to Florida State, I became a running quarterback. And I think to even the most diehard Florida State fans, when they think of him, they're going to remember him as a runner first who became a passer. But he'll tell you that he always had that in his game. Obviously, we noticed the massive improvement with him under Mike Norvell. But before you got him, were you thinking the same thing?
Not really, because I've seen him so many times at Florida State and had so many conversations with the staff. And Jordan and I have known each other for a couple of years. We haven't done a ton of work until recently. But I also kind of know, like, that family's baseball background. And usually if you get a guy who grew up, you know, tossing the ball around a little bit, not a football, but a baseball, or skipping rocks or whatever, throwing anything, that they normally catch on pretty quickly. And I think, you know, what we've seen out of Jordan the last couple of weeks is just like an efficiency throwing that has surprised me. Not that he can throw, or not that, you know, he's got plenty of arm, but it's just he's become a very efficient thrower as of late. And so there's been days that we've kind of walked away and just said, man, Jordan didn't miss all day.
Mm-hmm.
He's got a lot of arm talent. He's a good thrower. And obviously, you know, the best thing for him, and really this class in general, he's got a lot of film. And he's a very good football player.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And that's the thing. Like, you cannot ignore that. You can't ignore what you can do in the NFL with a guy who can do both things. But I don't think there's a throw on the field that he can't make. We always talk about arm strength. And if we use like a 1 to 10 scale, I would think Jordan's somewhere in that, you know, 80th percentile, which is plenty in the NFL.
Impressive. Denny Thompson, our guest, of course, he is with 6 points. And he joins Rick Ballew here on the home of the Jags. How is his footwork?
Well, I mean, obviously, you know, I don't know much about his medical. That's not my thing. But, you know, there's been, you know, obviously some challenges there, as everybody knows.
But going back to all the film and everything that you watched, I mean, pre-injury. I mean,
it was good. Florida State's footwork system is actually really involved and really good. They spend a lot of time on that. So for what he needed to do at FSU and what they needed to do offensively, like, it was right on script of what they needed. And I think it was a large part of why that offense ran as efficiently and as good as it did. But, you know, athletes, man, just athletes, I don't worry about footwork. Because at the end of the day, this is an athletic event. And if they can get themselves in a good position to throw on time, then that's really all we need out of this. Right,
mm-hmm.
So I think footwork a lot of times is a little bit over-exaggerated, and at times people kind of use that as a crutch. But if you look at, you know, look at all the 32 NFL quarterbacks, and what you'll find, they're balanced, right? They all get to the same place different ways. There's not one way to do this. And so if you've got a very fluid athlete the way that Jordan is, I think the last thing you want to do is turn him into a robot from a footwork perspective.
All right, we see the top four who are going to go early in the draft. There could be 5 quarterbacks who go before Jacksonville selects at 17. We'll see what happens. Where is Jordan Travis? What do you believe he can do at the NFL level?
I mean, the realistic part of me, knowing, you know, what he's up against as far as recovering from the injury and the questions that brings, fair or not, you know, thinks that he's, you know, a third round guy. If that wasn't a thing, knowing what I know now, I think he would be considered in that upper echelon of guys. And so maybe not with Caleb, right? I'm not mm-hmm. talking about that. I think Caleb's like at a different level than everybody else, but you can make a real argument that numbers 2 and number 6 are pretty close together. And if we got to see Jordan all the way through, I would think that would be numbers 2 through number 7, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know the way they would all work out. But I'll tell you this, like, if somebody gets him in the 3rd or 4th round, they stole. Because I feel comfortable saying he's going to be a long-time NFL player, and I would project him as eventually a starter.
You know, I've read all the scouting reports on him, Denny. As you know, I will about all of these guys, and typically this time of year, I read more of what I believe guys are going to project for the Jaguars. But I'm still trying to figure out what is his biggest weakness. I mean, I'm looking here at pace on stale through progressions, needs to become mm-hmm. more decisive as a passer. Occasionally signs of panic that turn into poor decision-making with the ball. Boy, we saw that improve at Florida State. So, I mean, when you look at his weakness, I don't know how much you read scouting reports, but what is the one thing that you believe he needs to improve on most?
To answer your question, I don't read scouting reports at all. I mean, I don't know the last time I've read a scouting
report. Well, good. That's good to hear. I didn't know that. Good.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. But I think that there's obviously some questions when you have a guy that did pull it down and run quite a bit, whether that was designed in the offense or not. That's a very good sign if you're an NFL team, because now you're playing an 11-on-11. But historically what that has brought is, wait, can he be on time and throw the ball? And so I think, you know, we've got that, just that picture of, well, if he's a runner, he can't also play in rhythm. But if you go plug the film in, that you quickly see that's not the deal, like, at all. He's getting deep into progressions, you know, a million times. And the thing that I love about George is he just loves the game of football. Like, this guy remembers, like, every snap he's taken. We were talking about the Kyle Hamilton interception. What was that? That was opening game of 3 years ago, something like that?
Yes.
And he's recalling it like it was yesterday afternoon.
Wow.
You know, so I just think the guy has got something to him that even I've always been a big fan. Always, I've been consistent on that. I've been a big fan of Jordan, but he has even surprised me. Just when things like rotational speed and just the way he picks up and the way his body responds to coaching and just cueing and learning about his body and learning how to throw a little bit. And he's so far ahead because he got here a little bit late with the injury. But, man, it's like this guy can tell himself, hey, I want to try this, and his body responds right away, and that's an elite trait. And that's the last thing I'll say about him is that when you start to read these scouting reports, like, if you want me to believe that elite traits are explosiveness and speed and arm power and we can get accuracy, well, then this guy's got all that.
Yeah.
So I don't really know. There's risk with everybody. I don't know why the perceived risk with him is higher than others, unless you're just talking about the injury, because he has shown it on the tour.
Hey, as we wrap up, have you gotten with Mac Jones since he's been back in town?
We've linked up a couple of times. I mean, I've known Mac since middle school. And so that's a long-term relationship. So he's come in and just thrown a couple of times, yeah.
Because I had a conversation with someone who's really involved and said this is a bigger deal than people want to realize. They think he can play, and obviously Trevor had 5 different injuries last year. The perfect case scenario is he doesn't get injured and you never see Jones. But if it happens, they believe – Jacksonville can win NFL games if he is the quarterback.
Oh, I don't think Mac Jones is done being a starter in the NFL. Mac Jones has not started his last game. This is a guy that just a couple years ago was thought to be possibly the best one in that draft that included Trevor. Right? And then you're a big Boston fan. Like, you know, I think anybody that knows the situation up there knows that was not all on Mac. Now, did he perform well? No. But that was just a really weird situation up there the last couple of years. But he's still the same Mac. He's good arm, like, deadly accurate, and just an elite brain. It's just really, truly an elite brain. So
Patricia is your offensive coordinator.
Right. Yeah,
Joe Judge is your offensive coordinator. I mean, you took special teams guys and a defensive rocket scientist and said, hey, you're calling our offensive plays. That's what Belichick did.
With a quarterback in his second year. It's not like you had Brady in his 12th year. It was just a really weird scenario. So I don't think Mac is done. I think this is a great landing spot for him, letting him kind of get his balance back and figure this thing out. But he looks spectacular, like he always does. He's a guy that when he's throwing, it's just like, geez, man, this guy's just a natural thrower.
Hey, tell us what's going on. I know you got a lot of good things happening as well, including your trips to Athens, Georgia.
Yeah, a lot of focus right now on Carson for me this year. Cortex and Tom Gormley and Will Hewlett are the heavy lifters in this whole project with the pro guys coming in town and all that. And I'm kind of focused a little bit on Carson the way I was with Anthony a couple of years ago. And so we're investing that time. I feel strongly that Carson's got a chance to do something special this year. And so I'm trying to get as much time with Carson as I possibly can. And it's been fantastic, man. He looks great. They've got a team that really could be special, I think, this year. And I think he's got a legitimate chance at doing what Caleb did.
He's
going all the way through, wire to wire, is thought to be the number one quarterback if he just handles his business right.
Be impressive, no doubt about it. Hey, Denny, always a lot of fun. Thank you. I know we'll do it again soon.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you.
There he goes. Denny Thompson, great stuff. He is with 6 points. talking about Anthony Richardson, who we had a couple of years ago, Carson Beck. I remember the one night when we were doing back-to-back shows, he came in here, Carson in here, and boy, I can't even think of the kid's name now. He was at Georgia Tech, and then he went off to Nebraska.
Jeff Sims.
Yes. Supposed to go to Florida State. Instead, with Georgia Tech, he beat Florida State as a true freshman in Tallahassee. God, I hate when I have to bring up stuff like that. But hopefully that's gone long ways down the road.
Yeah, I was a producer for that show. I think Carson was decommitting from Alabama that night.
Right, and the speculation was a lot
Florida.
Of Florida.
Yeah, exactly.
Because he was here and his dad was here. Yep. And
it was a big deal.
Boy, but both of them, you can tell, have been in the weight room. There's no doubt. And, I mean, they were what? Getting ready for their senior year in high school?
Oh, my God. Jeff Sims was like one of the – when he came in, I was worried.
He looked like he weighed 145
yeah,
pounds.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah, Carson was a little bit bigger, but it's impressive to see where they have gone, particularly Carson Beck, who could be the number one pick in next year's draft. Of course, Denny right now working with a lot of guys, including Caleb Williams, and that's great to hear that report on Jordan Travis. You know, I haven't spoken a lot on the Mac Jones thing because he's a backup quarterback, right? And the feeling is it's a one-year deal. You have until May 2nd to pick up these first, you know, these fifth-year options that only apply to first-round draft picks. There's no way they're going to pay him that amount of money. Now, I expect him to pick it up on Trevor, and for my money, I think they pick it up on Travis Etienne. Doesn't mean they can't sign Mac Jones, you know, to a contract extension to be a backup, but that was more than just a backup. And I was told directly that the five injuries to Trevor Lawrence has to be a concern. I mean, how can it not? He literally hurt himself head to toe. Five different injuries. And it's nothing against C.J. Beathard, who honestly, in his appearances, was, I want to say, above average, right? But they think if all of a sudden, you know, there's a game or two, whatever, and Trevor can't go, that you can bring Mac Jones in and he can win football games for you. There's not a lot of backup quarterbacks in the NFL where you'll hear privately that the team thinks, okay, we can still win a football game with a backup quarterback. I know it happens, especially nowadays, because so many starters are knocked out. But I just think that you should, if you're not already, maybe you already subscribed to that. And that whole image that you have from Boston, don't. Bill Belichick may go down as the greatest coach to ever be a part of the NFL. He really screwed things up at the end of his regime with the Patriots. He drafted horribly. And again, Matt Patricia, a defensive-minded coach, was calling plays, and Joe Judge, fired from New York, a special teams coach, fired by the Giants as the head guy, over there calling plays. It's totally messed up. Then you brought Bill O'Brien in this year, and it was too late. And obviously by then, the media had been all over Jones, and Mac Jones had shown some immaturity, right? He had been a very frustrated guy, probably should have handled things a little bit differently. But he's still a young guy. He's still, what, 24, 25-year-old man? So we'll see what ends up happening there. I think this could end up – well, actually, scratch that. I hope you never hear from Mac Jones. I hope he's on the sideline holding a clipboard because I hope Trevor Lawrence is your starting quarterback each and every game. All right, we got much more to do. You want to respond, you can. Best way to do it is on our text line. That is 641-1010, brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures.
And now, the starting lineup.
The Drill. Mornings. Jaguars Today, 10 to noon. Helmets and Heels, noon to 2. XL Primetime, 2 to 4. The Frangie Show, 4 to 6. Into the Night with Rick Ballew and Hacker. After Dark, evenings on 1010 XL.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory.
Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
Pizza's here.
Oh, great. I'd love some, but I'm worried about my stomach issues.
If you're worried about having diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, or loose, oily stools, it may not just be stomach issues. It could be a condition called exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI. With EPI, the pancreas doesn't release enough enzymes to break down food, but EPI is manageable. Use the symptom checker on identifyepi.com and talk to your doctor. That's identifyepi.com. Sponsored by AbbVie.
Baloo here for Smunez Vision. Why Smunez Vision? Well, I've been with Dr. Neil Smunez now since I got back to Jacksonville in 2006. 37 years of experience he has. Smunez Vision is a family organization that focuses on personal high-quality medical and surgical eye care. Dr. Catherine Smunez is fellowship-trained in cornea and cataract surgery and all refractive surgery. Combined, that's 30 years plus in laser eye surgery. Visit SmunezVision.com today. Here you can see.
For the greenest, luscious lawn on the block, choose the local legends, Roundtree Sod. Don't just settle for ordinary. Let Roundtree Sod deliver you a picture-perfect lawn. To get a free estimate, call 7414-SOD. 7414-SOD.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 15, 1947, Jackie Robinson becomes the first African-American to play in U.S. Major League Baseball on the Dodgers.
Are you 18 years or older, just got married, just got divorced, or have children? Listen up. Have you done your last will and estate planning? If you have questions, call Matt Hinson with the Hinson Law Firm. Reach him at 527-1700. Office is Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
Electricians, innovators, and tech enthusiasts, listen up. Miller Electric is shaping the future, and we want you to be a part of it. From healthcare and data centers, corporate offices, aviation, and industrial facilities, Miller Electric is powering the most exciting projects in Jacksonville and beyond. We offer not just a job, but a thrilling career with great pay and incredible benefits. Visit us at millercareers.com to apply. Miller Electric, where your skills meet our vision and equal opportunity employer.
There are three certainties in life: death, taxes, and if you stay in your home long enough, a new roof. Pick it here for our friends at Lockhart Roofing. Nobody better in Jacksonville. How do I know? They are a local certified Master Elite contractor, and that means they have a GAF Master Elite warranty. That's the best in the roofing industry. In this day and age, don't settle for cheaper discount roofers. Lockhart Roofing has been here for decades. They aren't going anywhere. Call my friends at Lockhart Roofing, 994-3851. That's 994-3851. Lockhart Roofing, Jacksonville's best for Jacksonville people.
Hey, Glenn here with B&B Oil. Do you have equipment that needs fuel? We can service any size event from a small wedding with a generator in a tight spot to large construction sites with multiple pieces of large equipment. We deliver all types of fuel and lubricants. We also have fuel tanks from 200 gallons to 2,000 gallons. And we can get larger if needed. So give us a call today or find us online at bb-oil.com. bb-oil.com.
Daily's Dash is not only your Jaguars game day stop, but a great place to grab a meal any day of the week. To honor the Jags and the fans, we've crafted the Duval Sub. The Duval comes with freshly sliced turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheese, topped with crisp lettuce, fresh tomatoes, and a double portion of our secret sauce, all served on a fresh roll. Come by your local's Daily's Dash today to get your delicious Duval Sub. Daily's is the official convenience store sponsor of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Any adventure, any task, any time. There's a CF Moto Utility ATV or UTV for any rider. See the full lineup at Ride Now Beach Boulevard. Venture seekers can start with the trail-tested capability and comfort of the Z-Force lineup. For the ultimate in UTV performance, check out the Z-Force 950. Find your utility ATV at Ride Now Beach Boulevard or online at cfmotousa.com. ATVs are recommended for the use only by riders age 16 years and older. ATVs can be hazardous to operate. CF Moto recommends approved training course for safety and training information.
Mia here. Looking to spruce up your home or business for the spring? Window Gang's exterior cleaning services will remove stubborn stains, restore windows to a clear shine, and ensure your gutters flow freely. Call 262-7300 for a free estimate.
I-9 Sports wants to make sure kids all over the First Coast can enjoy growing up on a field or in a gym. And right now, summer and fall registration is open. So make sure you find out what I-9 Sports offers in your area across Duval, Clay, and St. John's. I-9Sports.com. Enter 1010 in the promo code.
Frank Frangie here. I was born and raised in Jacksonville, and I love living here. But I also know how bad bugs are in Florida. So I trust Orange Environmental Services to handle all my pest control needs because they've got the best technicians and effective treatment. Their name may be Orange, but they think green. Orange Environmental has been serving the First Coast for over 50 years, and they now offer complete lawn maintenance services. Call Orange Environmental Services for peace of mind from bug problems today. Call them at 272-3284. That's 272-3284.
1010 XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Let's go into the night with Rick Ballew on 1010 XL 92.5 FM.
All right, our question for a couple of tickets to Guns N' Roses. Scotty Scheffler joined Tiger Woods, Jack Nicklaus, and who? As the fourth youngest to win two green jackets.
Seve Ballesteros.
There you go, the Spaniard.
And he never won again.
John Rahm became the fourth Spaniard to win a year ago in between Scheffler's victories. Boy, he had a rough go at it. He really did. A lot of these guys had rough goes at it.
It was fun to watch.
Yeah, it was great. It was just fantastic. And, you know, Valhalla's a month away. We'll see. I am a really big fan all of a sudden of Ludwig Åberg.
I knew you'd say that. He has a great swing.
Love him. He lives in Tallahassee.
And he's always smiling. There was like, I didn't know that.
He played at Texas Tech and he lives in why would you live in Tallahassee?
You can't even get a direct flight
out of Tallahassee. I mean, if you want to fly from Tallahassee to Jacksonville, man, they land in Lake City.
Maybe he just loves Florida State Athletics.
Yeah, I think he's with a Texas Tech girl. But
he's got a twin brother who's also really good. Last year they won on the European Tour in back-to-back weeks.
No.
The brother. So I'm excited to see these guys. Oh no, actually I'm mixing them up with Højbjerg.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Højbjerg. Yeah, he fell late.
Åberg does not have a twin brother.
Second place for a rookie, the third to do it ever, and that includes Will Zalatoris, who did it in 2021.
Who had a good weekend. We didn't know that because of CBS showing us zero shots. Dude, the coverage on Sunday, terrible, man. Like, it's basically Scotty and Morikawa. That was it, watching Scotty just walk the course. Like, no golf. It was so hard to watch. It sucked. They never show golf.
We ended up leaving with four holes to go.
I stopped watching around the same time.
I just listened to it on Masters Radio. Chirico had the call, and he was good, as you would expect. I have it taped. I usually like watching Jim Nance in the Butler Cabin, but I haven't gotten to it.
They did have a nice moment with Vern. Also, Tiger shaking Vern's hand behind the tree was really cool. I'm going to miss him.
I am too. An 82 for Tiger on Saturday. He just ran out of gas.
You could tell that he was in it to make the cut, and then after that was just like, all right, whatever.
And I enjoyed watching him play Thursday and Friday.
It was a grind.
Now, he said, even though he finished last, plus 16, he says he's going to Valhalla. He's going to Pinehurst, and he's going to Troon. So,
now, will he be a guy who's like a VJ who, you know, just shows up because he has a lifetime exemption? He's never in contention. He might make a cut here or there, like VJ did this week, actually, cash some checks.
I don't think so.
Neither do I, and I hope not. Like, I really hate seeing 15 over. Tiger Woods. Like, if you're not going to be, he says it every time. He's always asked the same thing. Do you think you can win? He always has the same canned answer. Yes, I wouldn't be here if I don't think I can win. I call BS on that. I don't think you, I think you know you couldn't have won this weekend, but I don't know, man. It's hard to watch. I hope he just quits.
I think he'll hang on to the Masters longer than the other three. That'd be just a guess.
Because of the course.
Yeah, I mean.
And maybe you could play like St. Andrews. There's always old guys that are competing when they play at St. Andrews.
The Masters is the only one that stays the same. We know that there's a rotation now with the PGA Championship in both Opens. Four courses with the British Open. But it was fun to watch Thursday and Friday. But, boy, Saturday got really, really ugly. No
and
doubt
like,
about
imagine
that.
Imagine him at like a U.S. Open setup right now.
No.
I don't want to see that.
He drove it. He hit plenty
pretty
of
good.
Fairways.
Yeah.
His putting late let him down, but it really kind of kept him in it Thursday and Friday.
It was from fairway to green. He was terrible.
And he was missing bad with his iron play. You're right. I mean, just really, really bad. And I know the wind was just nuts on Friday. On this day, 1947, Jackie Robinson, Brooklyn Dodgers, Ebbets Field. Historic day, historically speaking, in Major League Baseball. 1947, my goodness, what are we, 2024. I remember the 50-year deal in 97. And at that time, I believe they retired 42 all across Major League Baseball.
Yeah,
no,
there was
that
like
uniform again.
A few guys like Mariano Rivera was one of the he was like grandfathered in. But now that everyone wears it, like tonight, you'll watch a game, everybody will wear 42, which I love.
Yeah.
And more baseball news: John Sterling retiring effective immediately. If you don't know him, he's the Yankees play-by-play radio guy, and the Yankees win. The Yankees win. I hope it's not because of health reasons, but it probably is. You know, just you don't retire, you know, 20 games into the season like that. But
no, it doesn't happen at this particular time unless something did occur. I love the John Sterling story where he was reprimanded for wiping his mouth off on a tablecloth.
At a restaurant?
It was like in a press box.
Oh, my God.
I don't think it was in a restaurant. I think it was at a game or something, you know, like a buffet. He was like, I don't want to get up and grab a napkin. So
here we go. Yeah, Page Six called him out in 2008. Yankees radio announcer John Sterling is being called out for foul behavior in the stadium's press dining room. Quote, Sterling has made a habit of walking over to the dessert table, dipping his fingers into the ice cream barrel, one stadium worker told us, adding that the play-by-play vet also used the same tablespoon to repeatedly take samples. During the Boston series, he wandered over to the cake and pie section, broke off a piece of cake slice, ate it, and wiped his grimy hands on the linen tablecloth, leaving the remainder of the slice for someone else to eat.
He's my favorite Yankee of all time.
Happened.
I hate all Yankees except for John Sterling. I love that. That's like a Chris Farley move. That's a Belushi move. That's a great move. So, he's done at 85. We know one thing about the New York media. We'll find out why.
Oh, yeah.
That's coming. And before we head to this break, man, what about Spencer Strider now, man?
Yeah.
Already.
Unfortunately, I saw it coming right when it happened. You just knew that was going to be a Tommy John, elbow. Whenever you hear elbow, you just know what time it is. Luckily, it happened at the beginning of the season, so he'll be back next year.
The Braves are one of those teams that you can really look at and say they can win it all, and they still could win it all. Texas won it all without Jacob DeGrom.
I got two words for you. Trevor Bauer.
Yeah.
Go get him.
Why not? He's been cleared.
Absolutely.
Everything that was said about him
seems to be false.
It's amazing that he's not. He's like willing to sign for the league minimum.
Yeah, exactly. And the Braves have Marcell Ozuna on the team, who's been arrested countless times, and he leads the league in homers. Like, we don't really care. So Yeah, let's do it. Bring him down.
He threw 88 pitches in his last start, and his velocity was down from last year, 97.2, consistently through the 2023 season to 95.9. And mentioned discomfort in the elbow. There you go. The infamous Tommy John surgery. A big blow there for the Atlanta Braves. All right, let's put our final thoughts on this one. I'm taking tomorrow off. I don't really take weekdays off, but I am in this case because I got a big golf game, and I got Britt Floyd at the Florida Theater tomorrow night. So I'm going to take a Tuesday off, but I will tell you, I am already very excited to rejoin you at 6 o'clock on Wednesday.
This is our house. Yes, our house. Let's get a rock and roll.
Our house.
Hey, this is our house.
This is where we live.
1010XL, home of the Jaguars.
Hey, Hicken here. I couldn't be any happier than to join the George Moore Chevrolet family. When I say family, I mean it. Visit their beautiful showroom today off Atlantic Boulevard. Find out exactly what I'm talking about. No pressure, just friendly help. And whether you want a car, a truck, SUV, electric, pre-owned, you name it, George Moore Chevrolet has it. If you can't make it over to Atlantic Boulevard, no problem. MooreChevy.com is easy to navigate as any site you will try. It's never been more easy to use. George Moore Chevrolet. Together, let's drive.
This is Hayes Carline for First Florida Credit Union. I bank with First Florida Credit Union because I trust them. I can always count on them when it comes to the vast services they provide. First Florida Credit Union was voted Best Bank in the 2023 Best of Bold City Community Choice Awards, and it's easy to see why. I go to the branch off 210 in St. Johns County and the new Durbin location, but they have 10 branches in the Jacksonville area. You need to be banking with First Florida Credit Union. They're enriching people every day. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Opportunity Lender.
Denny Thompson here. Tackle burglars and protect your turf. Give yourself peace of mind catching everything around your home with Tyson Sound & Security's cutting-edge surveillance cameras. For safety and convenience, Tyson has you covered for all home cameras and security systems. I'm talking HD recording, night vision, and remote alerts all from your phone or computer. Call Tyson Sound & Security right now at 904-762-1000. Tyson Sound & Security, security and automation experts.
Dave Binion here with my son, Ammon, who is the air duct cleaning manager at Zero Res. So, Ammon, you may notice a little rattle in my voice and some puffiness in my eyes. That's because allergy season is coming on. Can Zero Res help?
Yes. Your health has a lot to do with the air you breathe. A clean and healthy home begins with clean air. At Zero Res, we can help clean the air in your home by cleaning your air ducts, cleaning the coils in your HVAC units, and fogging the system with a powerful antimicrobial that helps kill and control the growth of microorganisms in your air. We also have options for maintaining your clean air with our excellent inline air purifier and UV lights that will help keep your system clean and healthy. At Zero Res, we are more than just air duct cleaners. We're a clean air specialist.
Have Zero Res air duct specialists out, and right now we'll give you $50 off your air duct cleaning, and while we're at it, we'll give you $50 off your dryer vent cleaning. Zero Res.
Spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean.
C-E-R-O-R-E-C. Zero Res.
Who's on Jacksonville's big board?
This guy could give us a new spark.
1010XL covers every angle of the draft.
This your team?
Yeah.
Listen for draft previews brought to you by Big Brothers Big Sisters of Northeast Florida.
Now that's what I call high quality H2O.
If you want high quality water throughout your home, call your local water boy. We install equipment to solve any water problem. Waterboy J-A-X.
Chose C for CSS Fireplaces and Outdoor Living. They can transform your backyard with fire pits, pergolas, screen enclosures, and outdoor kitchens. And CSS handles the entire project from start to finish. You dream it, they build it. CSSOutdoor.com.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket, with benefits that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit ua234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
Certainly facing challenging economic times, I can't speak for all of us, but for me, comforting to know my money is in good hands with ITP Partners. Ticket here for ITP Partners. Jacksonville guys taking care of my Jacksonville money. I'll admit it, I don't understand a ton about the economy, higher interest rates, 401ks, but I do know as I move closer to retirement, I continue to watch my money grow. Thanks to Chris Bryan, Jeff Hartman, Reagan Wright, Dan Abel, and Reed Wingate. Get in the game, guys. ITP Partners, always there to help. For more info, Chris at ITPPartners.com or call 904-312-9751.
Our slogan, Know Before You Blow, applies to more than just DUI cases. Hi, I'm attorney Lee Lockett of Lockett Law. Battery charges can result in jail time and criminal convictions too, so know before you blow a gasket and hit a loved one or a stranger. Drug crimes like possession of marijuana and cocaine will land you in cuffs too, so know before you blow. In a boating under the influence case, you also have the option to blow or not to blow. So know your options. Know before you blow. Go to knowbeforeyoublow.com now. Office is Jacksonville.
It's back, the biggest jewelry sale of the year. Buy one, get one at Beard's Diamonds.
No other jewelry store in North Florida can match it. Buy any band and get the other one free.
The whole month of April.
Beard's Diamonds will beat any competitor's price.
At the St. John's Town Center.
This is Nia Lauren Stemple, former Florida State National Champion and the proud owner of NLS Cleaning. Just like on the gridiron, we tackle dirt and grime with unmatched precision. Whether it's your commercial property or your residential space, we are ready to take care of your exterior cleaning needs. NLSCleaning.net. You're shrimping
a bag. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, presented by FIS, with tickets starting at just $5, is back at 1-to-1 Financial Ballpark this weekend. Don't miss Coors Light Thirsty Thursday, Fireworks Friday and Saturday, and Military Appreciation on Sunday Family Fun Day. Tickets start at just $5. Log on to jackshrimp.com. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball. Affordable, family, fun.
Oh, you're the best. 1010 XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
All right, so Caitlin Clark goes number one overall to the Indiana Fever. According to SpotTrack, 4 years, $388,000? Is this right? I checked and make sure it was the correct SpotTrak. She's going to make this year $76,535. Next year, $78,000. This can't be correct. 2026, $85,873. In an option year in 2027, $97,000. I mean, she'll be fine. She's getting a ton of endorsements. But is that what the pay is right now for the top overall pick in the WNBA draft? I've never researched it before.
I don't know, but I know that Grayson Allen is making $70 million.
75.
Over 4 years. Yeah, that's why I know that the salaries are low, because I didn't know until Ice Cube offered her $5 million to play in the Big Three League.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone's like, oh, yeah, that's like four and a half more than she'll make in the WNBA. I was shocked by that, but I guess I shouldn't be. I mean, the league does nothing but lose money. The only reason it exists is because the NBA every season pays for it.
Yeah.
So
now,
yeah,
will ratings go up when she plays in this league after they went to college basketball?
Yeah, absolutely. They'll go up. Will it become like a, you know, every night we have to watch the whatever team she's on game? I don't think so. College basketball, women's college basketball, is so much more popular than the WNBA. Don't ask me why, but it is. And I think it just stays like that. I don't know if we're going to have 12 million people flock to watch her in the WNBA finals like we did in the Final Four.
Something else to keep an eye on from right now, the 15th through April 30th, is the second transfer portal timeline. Florida State, with 89 players right now, they got to get it to 85. And remember, they were hit with that NCAA penalty. The loss of five scholarships reduced over the next couple of years. So, you know, you can honestly make the case that I don't think Florida State wants to put all five on them next year to go from 85 to 80. The thinking would be maybe they try to get to 82, 83 this year. Currently, they have 89. Greedy Vance announced last week that he was going to enter the transfer portal. But, you know, there's a little bit of talk that they'd like to add a couple of players. So if you're adding to a list of 89, you're getting to 91, 92, 93, then all of a sudden you're talking about having to cut 8 to 10 players. And, you know, attrition always happens over the summer. And it's going to happen there, but they're going to have to make up their mind on what they're going to do. And I think at this particular time, with where they're at, I would assume it's going to be pretty good attrition, if that makes any sense. It's tough to lose players that can help you win. And for the record, I didn't like the loss of Greedy Vance. What it's saying is that some of these younger guys, like Earl Little, are perhaps playing better and may take away the reps. But Vance was a guy that you could rely upon with your two deep. All right, he was a guy who played on Saturday, and he had a lot of experience for them. Hey, something coming up on Wednesday night that we may get into is now the real hot name that is being dangled around the NFL is Brandon Ayuk. And reportedly, he unfollowed the San Francisco 49ers. And we know what that's all about. Yeah, that's huge. He has spoken on social media. But the Jaguars, as far as their odds, let's see here. 8th overall, 14-1 odds to make a deal with Brandon Ayuk. This really feels like it's all Pittsburgh. I mean, the Steelers have 2-1 odds. All right, then you have Carolina and New England at 6-1. You have Arizona 7-1. The Chargers 9-1. Then you go Bills, Giants, Chiefs at 12-1. Jacksonville at 14-1. What are you willing to give up to get Brandon Ayuk? I'd love to sit here and say it's going to cost you 2 first round draft picks this year, next year. I don't know that. I'm trying to remember what New York had to give up in order to get Brian Burns, right? And then they also turn around and sign Brian Burns to an incredibly lengthy contract. Jacksonville still has an opportunity to restructure some of these contracts.
So the Giants sent a 2024 second round choice and a 2025 fifth round choice and agreed to a swap of fifth rounders this year.
If that was the asking price for Jacksonville, I'd do that in a heartbeat. If you're talking about a second rounder this year and a fifth rounder next year, done. But you would also have to sign Brandon Ayuk to a 4-year deal, which is going to cost you what? $100 and something million? I'm not sure. They still could restructure Christian Kirk's contract and Cam Robinson's contract. Remember, the cap numbers this year for Kirk, $24,236,000. The cap number for Robinson, $21,909,000. So you could create money. And if you went out and got a guy like Brandon Ayuk, I absolutely believe that you could say goodbye to Zay Jones. And let me pull up Zay Jones here before the end of the program. I do remember that cutting Zay Jones makes a lot more sense if you do it post June 1st. If you do it right now, the dead money for Zay Jones would be $6,569,000, where you would save $4.1 million. It's mid-April. If you waited till June 1st and cut Zay Jones, you would only have to eat $3 million, and you would be able to recoup $7,735,000. I know others are saying, why not keep them both? Maybe they would. I'm just throwing that out there. They got to create some money. And again, with a massive signing bonus, we saw it with Josh Allen. Maybe not. Maybe they have enough right now. Let me give you the latest as I get set to say goodbye. According to Over the Cap, that's not right. Because it doesn't include Josh Allen. But anyway, last I knew, there was around $12 million of what Jacksonville had. And you're going to need at least 8 for your rookies. We'll solve that when we get with you again on Wednesday. That's it. I have an off day. Enjoy it, folks. I'll see you at the Brick Floyd concert tomorrow night at the Florida Theater. I'll rejoin J.J. LaSelva Wednesday at 6 on your home of the Jag.
Fun and game.